In this video, I am going to show you how to find axial load and column for its preliminary design. So let's get started. Suppose we have a plan. The column layout is as this. The center to center distance between column is taken as 5 meter in both direction x and y. Now this column takes the load from half of this span and half of this span. So that is, this column takes the load of this area enclosed in this dotted lines. So this is 2.5, this is 2.5, and this is 2.5, and this is 2.5. So the area equals to 5 into 5, 25 meters square. Let's suppose the building is 3-story. So this is ground floor, this is first floor, and this is second floor. Now we have to consider the self weight of this second and first floor to design the column of this ground floor. So first, assume 500 into 500 mm column. Second is live load in the slab. Let us assume live load is 2 kN per. Let us assume live load is 2 kN/m. Sorry, let us assume live load is 2 kN/m². So total live load equals to 2 × 25 equals to 50 kN. Dead load of slab equals to 25 × its area, that is 5 × 5 × thickness. Let us assume the thickness of slab is 125 mm. So 125 equals to, that is 25 × 5 × 5 × 0.125 equals to 78.125 kN. Dead load of beam. Assume the dimension of beam as 500 mm depth and width equals to 250 mm, and length of the beam is 2.5 + 2.5 + 2.5 + 2.5. So 2.5 × 4 length, and depth 0.5 into width 0.25 into unit weight 25 equals to 31.25 kilonewton. Dead loader wall custom. The length of the wall equals 2.5 into 4 into the height of the wall is 3 meter. In here, I am not subtracting the depth of the beam. Okay, you can do that also, but I am not subtracting the depth of the beam here. Into, let's assume the thickness of wall is 230 mm, so that is 0.23. Into the unit weight of the brick wall is 19, so we get 2.5 into 4 into 3, 0.23 into 19, 131.1 kilonewton. Now, surface finish. We have the area 25. Into, let us suppose marble finish of unit weight 27. So let us take the thickness of the marble flooring as 10 mm area. So that is 25 into 27.01. 6.75 kilonewton. Now total weight in second floor is sum of all the above loads, so that is, so total load second floor is sum of all the loads above, so that is
6.75 plus 31.25 plus 17.25 plus 50 plus 18.75 pl350.
This is second floor, this is first floor, and this is ground floor. So this load is combination of the load of this part and the load of this column, and this load is the combination of the load of this part and load of this column. Now we have to find its this load to design this column. Now total load, ground floor equals to 315.975 minus load of this column 18.75. So that gives us 297.225 kilonewton. So total load be considered for preliminary design. Of column equals to 315.975 into 2 plus 297.225, so it gives 929.175 kilonewton. We have to take the factored load equals to 1.5 into equals to 1393.7625 kilonewton. This is the load from which we design the column. To design the column, we have the formula PU equals to 0.4 FCK, AC plus 0.67 FY AC, where PU is axial load on member, FCK equals to is characteristic compressive strength of concrete, AC is area of concrete, FO is characteristic compressive strength of reinforcement, and AC is area of longitudinal reinforcement for column. Let us assume percentage of steel equals to 1.5, so percentage of concrete equals to 98.5. That is to say, area of concrete equals to 98.5% of total gross area, and area of reinforcement is 1.5% of total gross area, where AZ is gross area of section. So putting the value, we have PU is 1393.7625 kilonewton, changing it into newton equals into 1000 equals to 0.4. let us assume FCK is 25 into AC is 98.5% of AZ plus 0.67 into, let us assume FY is 500 into ASC equals to 1.5% of AZ. On solving this equation, we get AZ equals to gross area equals to 9369.831 mm square. So adapting square column is depth and breadth equals to square root of 9369.831 equals to 306.10 mm. Therefore, adopt 350 into 350 mm columns. So thank you for watching, guys. Subscribe to the channel for more videos like this.